And now it's not just the Phillies. The Eagles also dealing with a coronavirus, with a high-profile member of the team tweeting that he has now tested positive. Our Dan Koob has more on that and the fluid situation now facing local teams as a result of the virus.
Lane Johnson is by far the biggest name on the Eagles COVID-19 list, but it's an ominous start to a football season that already has a lot of people hesitant.
It's going to be hard to control this, you know, especially in that sport.
Eagles fans still want their football, but will they get it? Lane Johnson, Nate Gary, and Jordan Mailata, all placed on the Eagles COVID list, doesn't mean they have it. Anyone who has close contact with a positive case gets put on the list. But Johnson said in a Twitter post he has contracted the virus. Quote, I have and will continue to take this seriously and encourage everyone else to do so as well.
And without being crude, like those guys, they're going to be banging, they're going to be spitting. They're, like, it's going to be unavoidable to do something like that. So I don't know if that's going to be able to happen or not.
We got to find a way to contain the players, so they don't have to go back, you know, the city life or partying or anything like that, so they don't bring it back into the facility.
The list shows the fragility of the situation. Mailata and Johnson are both offensive tackles, leaving the Eagles to start their training camp down two players at the same position. The Phillies are feeling something similar, seemingly dodging exposure from a Marlins team that currently has as many as 18 positive cases in their clubhouse. The Fish continue to quarantine in Center City. The Phillies continue testing their players daily.
We anticipated there would be positive cases. There would be bumps in the road, and we would all, as an industry, have to do our best to get through them.
The Phillies have not seen the inside of Citizens Bank Park for a baseball game since Sunday. They won't again until Saturday, a scheduled doubleheader against the Toronto Blue Jays. Outside Citizens Bank Park, Dan Koob, CBS 3 Eyewitness News.